गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. लेट अस स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर टुडे. की एलिमेंट्स ऑफ अ डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट. सिंस योर चाइल्डहुड यू मस्ट हैव सीन द स्प्लेंडर ऑफ एन इलेक्शन कैंपेन. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम ड्यूरिंग इलेक्शंस पेरेंट्स एंड एल्डर्स डिस्कस पॉलिटिक्स एंड द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ सर्टेन कैंडिडेट्स एंड पार्टीज winning or losing elections. You must have also seen leaders addressing election meeting and conversing with folded hands on cars or jeeps, distributing pamphlets and leaflets. Indeed, an election is a festival to celebrate democracy. Elections. Elections are the very heart and soul of the democratic polity. Let us learn by example how the non-white people in South Africa struggled in decades and sacrificed their lives to secure the right to participate in elections. Apartheid was practiced in South Africa before independence. South African people were divided into white, black, Indian and colored races. As per the law of the land, these races were not allowed to mingle with each other, to live near each other, or even use common facilities. South Africa was governed by apartheid laws. That means separation on the basis of race. The minority population of whites ruled the majority of people who were non-white. The white dominated all walks of life. The non-whites led an inferior and miserable life. There were separate hospitals and ambulances for white and non-white people. There were separate buses, trains, even bus stops. Non-whites were not allowed to vote. The most fertile and irrigated lands were reserved for white people. The blacks and colored people had to cultivate fertile, infertile, barren, and marshy lands. The principle underlying all these discrimination was white were by birth superior to colored people. The blacks were forced to learn Afrikaans, the language of whites, at schools. The blacks had natural affinity for their mother tongue, Zulu, that was an African language, but they had forcefully learned Afrikaans, that was the language of white. Decades of protest against atrocities of police resulted in death of thousands of blacks. Often their property was destroyed and the houses set on fire. The black struggle was spearheaded by an organization called African National Congress, and its leader Nelson Mandela kept in prison for 27 years. Ultimately, the blacks succeeded, and in 1994, South Africa became an independent democratic country. Nelson Mandela became its first president. Today, citizens are considered equal and have the right to vote in an election. Every citizen is equal in the eyes of law. Justice is available to every citizen. Equality and justice are the hallmark of a democracy. And how it is possible? When they acquired democracy and they started electing their own leaders. So, elections are very important in a democratic country because through elections, people choose their leaders. That's all for today. Thank you. Have a good day. In the next class, we will know about people's participation in our democracy.